In the summer of 1945, after years in the making, a top secret mission began, carrying a weapon unlike anything the world had ever seen. One bomb, born in secrecy, would change history forever. On the morning of July 26, 1945, the Portland-class cruiser, USS Indianapolis, reached her destination in the North Mariana Islands to a small speck of land called Tinian. The crew were woefully unaware of their secretive cargo. Few people on Earth knew what the contents of the inside of that box contained, but the world would soon come to understand the gravity of destruction that the war would bring. Unfortunately for the Indianapolis, most of the crew would never know how valuable their trip was, as less than a week later, the USS Indianapolis would be torpedoed and sunk by the Japanese submarine I-58, resulting in the loss of over 800 men. Despite the loss of the cruiser, the ship had performed its duty of safely transporting its secretive cargo, for with inside the contents of that box were the core components for a bomb. But not just any bomb, this bomb. This is the L-11 nuclear bomb. More specifically, this is an inert replica of the L-11 nuclear bomb, which also goes by the name Little Boy. Now, Little Boy would be a result of the Manhattan Project, which was initiated in 1942 as a means for the United States in partnership with the United Kingdom and Canada to develop a nuclear weapon before Nazi Germany could. The Manhattan Project would be directed by Major General Leslie Groves of the Army Corps of Engineers and tested by engineers and scientists led by Robert J. Oppenheimer at the classified nuclear site in Los Alamos, New Mexico. In just 3 short years, the teams at Los Alamos would be able to come up with 2 different kinds of nuclear weapons. The first would be this type here. Now, this is what we call a gun-type device. It is called this because there's a rather large rudimentary gun on the inside of this weapon. The second kind of nuclear weapon developed during the war was an implosion-style device. Now, this implosion-style bomb, callsign Gadget, would be the first nuclear bomb tested at the Trinity site on July 16, 1945. The implosion-style bomb, now called Fat Man, would be dropped on Nagasaki on August 9, 1945. Now, the reason why the implosion-style bomb was detonated during the Trinity tests instead of the gun-type bomb was because scientists were far more confident with how the gun-type bomb worked rather than the idea of pressing a plutonium core with Comp-B explosives. However, just because scientists were confident with the gun-type bomb didn't mean that things went smoothly. At first, the gun-type bomb was much longer, 17 feet long in fact, which helped give it the name Thin Man. Now, the main difference between the 2 atomic bombs dropped during World War II was the type of nuclear material they used for nuclear fission. Scientists originally wanted to try plutonium-239 in their gun-type bomb, but found out that the plutonium-239 produced by the graphite reactors at the time contained plutonium-240 as an impurity. Although this doesn't sound too different, plutonium-240 goes into nuclear fission thousands of times faster than the plutonium-239 does. This means that the bomb would go critical much faster and would detonate too soon, hence not deliver the full potential of a nuclear blast. Therefore, the scientists figured out that the plutonium would not work in the gun-type design, but uranium-235 would. Uranium-235 is an isotope of uranium that, when split, can release a massive amount of energy. This split inside the bomb would be caused by firing a group of rings made out of enriched uranium into a smaller group of rings which are also made out of enriched uranium. The bomb is over 10 feet long and has a diameter of 28 inches, which meant that the bomb had to have a specially made pit in order to fit while it was loaded into the B-29 bomber. What is interesting to note is that in the lead time to the bombing of Hiroshima, there were 8 assemblies of the bomb on Tinian, named L-1 through L-7 and then L-11. Now, 3 of these bombs would be dropped into the ocean to ensure that all components worked. L-11 would be the only bomb in it to have uranium, and that, of course, was dropped on Hiroshima. The bomb at first appearance looks like an oversized conventional bomb, until you notice some outstanding attributes like these rods at the front, which are the altitude radar antenna, which are used to measure the altitude of the bomb so that it detonates at the desired height. These 3 plugs are the arming safety plugs. Now, until the bomb was in flight and en route to target, there'd be 3 green plugs here which would cut off the electrical current to the primers in the gun, ensuring the safety of the weapon on the ground and during transport. The 3 green plugs would be removed in flight by the weaponeer William Sterling Parsons. Those green plugs would be replaced by 3 live red plugs, allowing the electrical current to go from the battery of the bomb to the primers at the rear of the bomb. Just behind that, on the inside, is a barometer that was added for redundancy in case there were unaccounted for external radio waves. This way, the weapon would not be inadvertently detonated before reaching the desired altitude. At the rear of the weapon are boxtail fins, which are put in place to stabilize the weapon. On the inside of the bomb, starting at the rear and running the majority of the length, is a 72-inch smoothbore barrel and was 6.5 inches in diameter. At one end of the barrel, there'd be three electric primers, which, when set off, would ignite 4 2-pound cordite silk bags. Cordite is a smokeless powder made from nitroglycerin, nitrocellulose, and petroleum jelly, and was very popular in artillery at the time. Just in front of the powder would be a projectile tungsten carbide disc. Now, this disc would add like a wad in a shotgun shell and would help propel the projectile down the barrel. The projectile in question is 9 rings made from enriched uranium weighing 86 pounds, and at the other end of the barrel are inner uranium rings weighing 55 pounds. On the inner barrel face are 4 polonium initiators mounted on the barrel's end, which is made out of tungsten carbide. These initiators would, as the name suggests, initiate the nuclear reaction upon the impact of the uranium rings. This nuclear impact would occur for the first time in human history on August 6, 1945. The B-29 Enola Gay, commanded by Paul Tibbets, would guide his silver plate B-29 to the target city of Hiroshima at an altitude of 32,000 feet. As the mainland would come into view, the safety plugs would be replaced by red plugs, and the bomb would then be live. At 8:15 a.m., the bullseye for the city, the Aioli Bridge, would come into the crosshairs of the bomb site, at which point, Little Boy would be dropped. As soon as the bomb was released, an internal clock started its countdown, verified by the barometer and the radar altimeter. 44 seconds later, and 30,000 feet closer to Earth, history would be made. At 1,900 feet above the ground, the desired altitude had been reached, and the battery would send voltage to the primers. The electric primers would go off, igniting the 8 pounds of cordite, propelling the 9 uranium rings and carbide disc forward at 1,000 feet per second. The uranium rings would travel 42 inches to the other side of the barrel, where they would fit snugly over the inner uranium rings and impact the 4 polonium initiators fixed on the barrel's end. The following carbide disc would compress both inner and outer uranium rings together, at which point nuclear fission occurred, immediately followed by nuclear detonation. At the moment of detonation, there was a blinding flash, and anyone and anything within 3/4 of a mile were instantly vaporized. Buildings turned into rubble and people into shadows. The radius and total destruction was roughly 1 mile, with widespread fires covering another 4 miles. On board the Enola Gay, the crew felt the shockwave hit the aircraft like a close burst of flak. They were then able to witness a mushroom cloud rise over 60,000 feet into the air as they started their return voyage to Tinian, where they'd be welcomed as heroes. Despite the destruction, the Japanese did not give in. So then the plutonium implosion bomb, Fat Man, would be dropped 3 days later on Nagasaki by the B-29 boxcar. Only after another Japanese city would be obliterated did the Japanese concede. Over 70 to 80,000 people instantly lost their lives, with another 75,000 people dying of radiation-induced cancer in Hiroshima within the following months and year. Earlier in March of 1945, over 100,000 people were killed in the firebombings of Tokyo in Operation Meeting House. That operation saw 279 B-29s drop over 1,600 tons of incendiary bombs, razing Tokyo to the ground. And less than 6 months later, the US would unleash almost the same amount of devastation with just this device here. If you would like to know more or see this Little Boy replica in person, be sure to come on over to the National Museum of Military Vehicles. If you like this kind of content, please be sure to let us know in the comments.